Hi everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and right now a lot of us designers are struggling. Maybe some of you have been laid off from your job or you've seen your freelance just plummet. And then a lot of us are working from home and trying to get used to that. Our profession isn't really on the front lines like nurses or other healthcare workers, but it's definitely still challenging for us. Personally, I've seen my freelance business completely come to a screeching halt. My clients' clients have stopped having them do work, so my clients can't give me freelance either. So I've really had to turn my focus towards other things to try to supplement my graphic design income. So that's what I want to talk to you about today. Some ways to make money as graphic designers that don't include freelance necessarily. Number one, sell your designs on products. There are currently a lot of places to sell your designs on products online. You just would create your design, make it a high quality PNG file with a transparent background, and then upload to sites like Redbubble, Zazzle, Society6, Threadless, and there are quite a few more than that. Those companies put your artwork on a product. They don't actually create the product yet, but they show it on their website, what it would look like on a t-shirt, a water bottle, a sticker, a lot of different products like that. Then when somebody orders that, they create the product themselves and ship it out to the customer. You never have to be involved with the product itself, which is really great because it doesn't cost anything. Now, the downside is you don't get a lot of money. They take most of the cut. So if you were to sell, let's say, a sticker on Redbubble, you would get anywhere from 50 cents to a dollar. A t-shirt would bring you somewhere around $3 to $5, and then the other products have different amounts that you would make for a sale there. So although you're not making a lot per sale, if you have a lot of products out there, that's going to translate to, you know, a pretty good income every month. And there's not a lot of risk. You don't have to pay to put your products on the site, and there's no overhead. You don't have to buy the products themselves or anything like that. If you want to learn how to sell your images and stuff on Redbubble, I do have a video for that, and I'll leave the link in my description below. Number two, sell graphic design files to other designers. You can sell your files to other designers on Creative Market and sites like Shutterstock, 123RF. Those are all stock image agencies. Designers use these files, they'll buy them, because they speed up their process so much. And a lot of large and small graphic design agencies have subscriptions to these sites, so the designers that work there can use them as much as they want. Your profit from a sale on, say, Shutterstock or 123RF is going to be pretty low, though. Usually it'll run from 25 cents to a dollar, so it makes sense to have a ton of images on these stock websites to be able to pull a decent amount of money every month. Depending on who buys that image, though, you can see up to $100 per sale on your images. It just doesn't happen very often. On Creative Market, you set your own prices, and then Creative Market takes a cut and you get what's left over. So it can really vary on how much you make on that site. If you want to learn how to upload your images onto Shutterstock, I also have a video for that, and you can take a look. I'll put it in the description below. Number three, sell design files to crafters. Although this probably sounds a lot like what we just talked about, your target audience with this type of file is going to be quite a bit different. These files look a lot more crafty or kind of cutesy almost. And if you want to know what your files should look like, go out on Etsy and just type in files for crafters and you can see a lot of what's selling now. Design bundles is another kind of digital marketplace like Etsy, but you already have to have another storefront already set up like Etsy. You can also put a portfolio somewhere online. That is one requirement that Design Bundles has that Etsy does not. As you may have guessed, I also have a video out there on how to upload to Etsy. So take a look at that. It's in the description. Oh, and I almost forgot. The profits for Etsy and Design Bundles are pretty much up to you. You get to set your own price there, but I would keep it around $2 or $3 per digital file downloaded. Otherwise, you might not be very competitive. Number four, teach online. If you're pretty good at explaining things to people, you can use your wealth of graphic design knowledge to create courses on Skillshare or Udemy. pick something that you know better than anyone else. So maybe it's Adobe Illustrator. You can create courses around that. Or maybe you know graphic design theory better than anyone you know. All you really need to create classes are the video camera on your phone, a few lights from hardware stores, that's what I'm using, and you probably want to invest in a decent lapel microphone. That'll run you about probably around $20 on Amazon. With Udemy, students buy your class and you get a cut. And with Skillshare, they pay for a subscription to all the classes on Skillshare, and you get paid for every minute that a student watches your class. Now, the amount you're going to get paid on those two platforms is really going to vary because it depends on the quality of your class and if people like watching it. But I've heard of people making $5 a month, anywhere to $100,000 a year on Skillshare and Udemy. And of course, it makes sense to make as many classes as you can that are high quality, that will always increase your monthly income. Now, I don't have a class on how to make a Skillshare class or a Udemy class yet, but maybe I'll make one at some point. So please let me know what you all are doing to supplement your graphic design income in the comments section below. And that's my video for this week. If you liked it, please click the like button, and I'll see you next week with another graphic design video. Thank you.